Hi there. In this video, we are going to be taking a look at these two AUDACs from France speakers. I have no idea how to actually pronounce AUDACs, but yeah. That's not the purpose of this video. These were not bought as a pair. I bought at a point one of them, and then randomly I saw somebody else selling a second one. It had the dust cap pushed in, but does that matter? Not really. Two tiny holes also in the membrane. Again, does not really matter. And they look quite the same, so I don't think there is a big age or use difference between them. Now, what I want to do in this video, give them a bit of a clean on this basket, which is actually pretty cool. Let me zoom out if I not in out if I can. It has this really interesting rounded shape to it, so they are quite flat speakers. Alnico magnet from what I see. I don't know the power of them, but they are 3.5 ohms and diameter, as you can see, about 16.5 centimeters. Ooh, almost broke one of them. That's not good. Anyway, and we will also obviously give them an audio test and see how they sound. They are not off center or anything, so they should work perfectly and hopefully sound good. We'll see. They are quite interesting because they also have these ridges in this area. I don't think the speaker actually moves. I've seen speakers with somehow a double surround, so they have one on the exterior and they have somewhere here another surround like this one. Those somehow move in two stages, but this I don't think it's something like that because it's quite firm in this area, and as you can see, it has something to make it even stiffer. So maybe they made them just for the stiffness of the cone itself. So yeah, let's clean them in high speed and be back. As for the dust cap, and yeah, just wanted to mention they don't have an identical color. One of them it's a bit less bluish and a bit darker. I thought it was from the dirt on it. Nope, that's just its color. Maybe over time they had different environment and that changed the color. I do not know. But anyway, this normally you would straighten by using a vacuum cleaner on its low power setting and making sure you do not rip it off, but in this particular situation, this being how you call it, a paper one, I think I can do it with a needle. And yes, I can, because you will barely see this tiny hole, as this thing already has holes in it. Did I say paper? This is a cloth one. So, not a real problem if we will have a tiny hole in the center, but on a paper one, this would show up quite badly, so that would be a no-go. But on this, good enough in my book. But yeah, sooner or later, I bet someone will poke a finger in it again, because that's what people do when they see these surrounds, and this is quite soft, as you can see. So the second somebody tries to poke a finger in it, it will go down. So there's that. Let's give them a test. I can tell you from the start, these are highly efficient speakers because I'm hearing a bit of hiss from my amp, and that only occurs when I deal with extremely efficient speakers. This is what we are paying. Not really appropriate for this type of speaker, but whatever, it's just a quick test. Then we will give it something else with a bit of piano and other things. And I already hear a bit of rattling. You can hear that. So, is there something caught in the voice coil? Probably. Oh, I hate this. This is the deal with old speakers. Sometimes debris gets. You can hear it. You can get debris in the voice coil, and you need to force the speaker to get it out, because it's near impossible to basically open up these things. And many times the debris is not actually inside, so I could simply remove the dust cap or something. It's actually on the outside, so much deeper opening up would be required. Yeah, most time I can get it out just by tapping on this or forcing it to move more than it actually should. So I will try to do that with this particular speaker. It's annoying. My bad. It was actually this particular wire. Somehow it started to touch right in here. When you have this kind of issues, you just listen carefully and see from what point in the membrane the sound actually comes from, and it was coming from around here. So that made me think that this is somehow to blame. So we should have zero rattling, and let's make sure the other one doesn't have the same issue. It almost has it. Look at that wire where it goes, and it shouldn't go like that. So let's move it, and much better like this. Yeah, that's it with old speakers. You can see in my videos, you never know what you are getting and what you are actually dealing with. Always need to make repairs, don't force anything, and hope for the best. Let's give this thing sound again, hopefully without any weirdness. Yeah. My phone just stopped, because why not? Yep. Zero weirdness. And this is highly efficient, because normally I give them the max and I'm at 2/3 now. Okay, this sounds good. Let's try something else. Okay, for their size and their how do you call it when somebody is really old? I don't know. Anyway, doesn't matter. Their age, damn it. I think that is what I was searching for. They sound good. So now with an app, I'm going to show you hopefully today if I actually can. Where is it? Yeah, this particular app, it can actually give us a graph on the frequency response that it records to the microphone of the phone, and I can actually generate logarithmic sweep. I set 30 to 20,000 hertz in 15 seconds on, and I go to the analyzer and I need to crank up the volume. And you can see it being generated, and obviously I will shut up when I do this test for real. And I have some standard conditions, as much as I can make them standard in this environment. Lower the volume. This is just so it gives you an idea of the frequency response. This is nowhere near professional stuff. So yeah, I test like this every single speaker. Yeah. Hope it gives at least a bit of info. At least it allows me to compare the speakers that I have one to the other. So yeah, I will do the test with the other to make sure both of them are working. We already know this is okay. And I will also do a bit of an excursion test on the other one. Yes, it's an old speaker. You are not really supposed to do that. They are not designed for big excursion or whatever, but you will just see the membrane move a little bit. Obviously, I will not push them. That would be just dumb. But yeah, some people like to see that, so I try to deliver. Because why not? It's not that difficult, and if you don't push the speaker, you should not damage it. So let's get to testing. Whoa. Okay, so from this point to about this point, this is one of the most linear speakers that I have seen. In free air, again, without real test conditions, just in my normal way of testing these speakers, this is one of the best. So for a mid-range, this speaker, it would be awesome. Yes, it's not a bass speaker, obviously, and it falls quite quickly in the high frequency, but mid-range, whoa, awesome speaker. So, yeah, let's go to the, how you call it, the excursion test. Say these are really nice speakers, and I like the way they sound. They are quite clear and accurate with the sound. If you try to push bass through them, they will start to distort because they are not made for that, obviously. But yeah, good. If you have any info on this particular model, like when it was manufactured or on what it was used, yeah. Give us please the info in the comments. And yeah, quite happy with them. So yeah, for other videos you can see some speakers down there. I think I have others somewhere out of the frame. Check out my channel, so there's that. Maybe subscribe, give this video a like, and as always, see you in the next one.